Hello, YouTube. This is Smooth Cat coming again with
Big Kool from Colossal Boxing Talk.
And today we get to interview a future Hall of Famer, a legend in his career, and in my opinion, the pound for pound hardest puncher of all time, Mr. Julian the Hulk Jackson. How you doing? How you doing, Hulk?
I'm doing great, man. One love, you know. Just wanna say hello to all the fans and. You know, blessings.
Okay. Well.
Yeah, we hanging here in Big Ben, getting ready for a fight on the
20th
with Julian.
Okay. Now Julian, the first question I want to ask you is, now, the transition from being a fighter to a trainer. What are some of the mental aspects you had to change? Well, with being a trainer now instead of a fighter.
Wow, that's a good question. Again, you know, I think the transition was very good because, you know, a lot of people say that, well, you know, you've been boxing for so many years and you've been a world champion, even in the limelight. Did you miss it? And to tell the truth, just the fact that I was able to transition a coach helped me a whole lot and made it a lot easier for me. And, you know, I really believe that after myself, I got a lot of insight and understanding, you know, as far as my coach is concerned and working with him and was able to basically, you know, transcend and, you know, sort of pass the baton to my son, and I was able to, you know, look at their defense, realize the mistakes that I made as a boxer as well, and, you know, using your jab and your defense, and being a defensive fighter as well as an offensive fighter. And I think that worked a whole lot for me.
Okay, okay. Hey, I definitely respect that answer. Be cool. Julian, this is a question I always want to get a chance to ask you. Now, now you know, coming up in the 80s and the era of the Fabulous Four. Now, out of the Fabulous Four, is it any one of those guys that you wanted to make like a dream fight with, but if not all?
I remember that Shiva Relena said he would fight the winner of myself and Terry Norris, and I won, and he was gonna be my next fight, and he surprised me and actually decided not to fight me, and fought the loser, Terry Norris, and I actually went to that press conference without weighing in, and I think it was in Madison Square Garden, and I interrupted it because I was really upset. You know, it was an opportunity for me to fight Chiller Leonard, to have that opportunity, taken away by him saying that he actually was on the mic. Sugar Ray Leonard actually went on the mic and said, "Julian, I'm not going to fight you. Why? Because you hit too hard." And that really made things, I think, really tough for me, because it was an opportunity for me to be a legend like, you know, Sugar Ray Leonard. And my hat goes up, you know, my hat tipped to, Terry Norris, and he went in there and did a good job and actually, you know, beat Sugar Ray Leonard.
Yeah, he put a beating on Sugar Ray Leonard. He did.
Yes, he did. And as a matter of fact, I was looking for a rematch with him, but he didn't want a rematch with me. I was willing to give him a rematch after knocking him out, but he said no way.
Okay.
Speaking of a potential fight with Sugar Ray Leonard, that would have been a terrific fight, because you would have been basically could he have made your power for 12 rounds, and you know, or could you get him in a corner to, you know, land the big shot? Because we all know that he was an elusive, you know, very, very, very skilled boxer, and you was no slouch in the boxing department as well. But it would have been definitely a fight.
Yeah, I thought he was very similar to Terry Norris. They had similar, style, and I felt that it would have been a tremendous fight, a boxer, a puncher, and a boxer, you know, and I was willing to go in there and take an opportunity, and it just didn't happen. I'm sure Ray Leonard would have been one of the biggest names that I would have been able to, you know, fight, and it just didn't happen.
Okay.
That's a shame it didn't happen. It really is, Smooth.
It truly is the same. Hey, also, now I'll say this. Now, a dream fight I would have loved to see you in is you versus Tommy Hearns. I would have loved to see that fight, especially at 154, when Tommy Hearns was moving up and they were calling him one of the greatest at 154. But now is that a fight that you would have loved to have? And if you would have fought him, how would you see that fight playing out?
Tommy Hearns was tall, and knowing that his legs was one of his weak points, and going to the body would have been something that we would have definitely worked on, and eventually opening up the head, you know, later on, and I felt that those were fights that I believe that would have been such a thriller. I think probably would have gone down in history as one of the, you know, best fights of the year. But again, you know, we have a lot of promoters and managers that in the game, you know, to make sure that, you know, they got the upper hand, they got the best opportunity or chance. And,
right.
That's the way it was. And again, here it is. I'm a trainer, I'm working with my boys, my sons, and I understand it more now than ever that you've got to, in a sense, make things a lot better or easier for you as a fighter, and your coaches and your managers. Trainers have to sit down and come together and say, "Look, this will be a better fight for me." And I realized that, because of my style and because of my power, it was not a good thing for
a lot of different fighters that were coming up, name fighters were coming up to fight me. And that's the way the game is, you know. you know, you pick and you choose fighters that you feel that, your boxing can stand a good chance winning.
I definitely agree with that. I definitely think that, you know, each fighter in China or promoter knows their fighters' limitations, and that's why we see some of the matchups we've seen in the past and as well as present. My question is, on Facebook or social media in general, you get put in a lot of mythical matchups with today's junior middleweights and middleweights. I wanted to know if you could fight someone from the early 2000s up to now, who would it be and why?
In terms of 154 to 160. Who would I like to fight right now? Oh man, I tell you what, you know, I look at Golovkin. he's 160, but he's unpredictable, but still, you know, as a fighter, I felt that that would have been a war. I felt that, I'm up here training, and I'm in the gym here at Big Bear, and I see him, and at times, you know, I go back and I think back, and I would say I would have loved to fight him. You know, looking at his style and looking at and being able to read him, I think it would have been an exciting fight. I think it would have been a fight that the public would want to see. I think Golovkin would be that fighter that I would maybe want to fight.
Yeah, I agree. That has trilogy written all over it. You know,
oh, man.
Both explosive, skillful fighters, man. It just, that would have been an epic fight. Man, the matches we could have got, if sometimes the stars would have lined up, would have been terrific.
I agree. You know what? Now, I'll say this, and out of all the present fighters today, is it any fighter in general that reminds you the most of yourself as a fighter?
I would say this kid from Jamaica.
Walters.
Nicholas.
Nicholas Walters.
Just one.
Yeah.
Comes up with the energy that he comes up with, you know, and he's very explosive, you know. He don't have a one punch knockout record, but just his meaner, you know, the way he goes into a fight reminds me of myself.
Okay.
I definitely can see that, you know. I definitely can see, you know, the jab and the length and height that he has over his guys in his weight class. I can definitely see that. My question is, being in such a brutal sport like boxing and going through some of the things that you did you ever try and discourage your son from boxing, or did you encourage him to, you know, try it and see if they liked it, which obviously they do?
To tell the truth, whatever they, you know, wanted to get involved in, I was 100% behind of them. I believe in supporting, you know, my sons in whatever endeavor they would have. And I felt that my youngest son, John, had more of a, you know, in mind for boxing from a little kid, because he would always gravitate to the boxing magazines and stuff like that. My oldest son, Julian Jr., you know, I thought would have been the chivalry of his time coming up. He was so fast. He was so, leg works, and he was tremendous. But I think he preferred, getting involved in communication, working with a lot of the, you know, technical stuff. He's a technician right now in the Virgin Islands, and I'm so glad that I didn't, you know, force him to get involved in boxing, but, to go after whatever he wanted to go after. But,
Julius, my second oldest, you know, I to tell the truth, he was my biggest boy in stature and all of that, in weight, and but somehow he didn't give me that, you know, that desire that he wants to be an athlete or a boxer. He was very good in baseball and was very good in school, very good brain, have a good brain, you know, but eventually John and Julius, I guess, was instrumental in, you know, pulling him into the gym. And the rest is history. He fell in love. He took the line and the hook, the line and the sinker, man. And now he is, you know, running in the fourth boxing council and making a name for himself and really going up the ladder. And again, we expect some big things from Julius. He's a rough, tough opponent. He can take a punch and he can give a punch. And that's what's good about him.
I definitely agree with you. It's always good to have that support. So, you know, hey, like you said, we're looking forward to, you know, John and Julius to do big things in boxing.
Most definitely. Hey, go ahead.
Yeah, I wanted to mention that, you know, I always tell my son, win, lose, or draw, we are winners. Why? Because, you know, of our faith, you know. Faith is what makes the difference in anybody's life. And I believe once you respect boxing will respect you. And I think that's why I've been around so long. A lot of people tell me, man, you look like you're ready to go into the ring. You look like you're the same weight, 160 pounds, and that is because, you know, I respect the sport, and the sport respects me, and that's why I really believe that, you know, the sky is the limit for my boys, and I've tried to train them in that aspect, that in order for them to get to the top, you know, they got to get off of their butt and work for it, and they got to make decisions that is going to, I think, advance them, and rather than decisions that will, you know, keep them back. And that's one of the mindset that we have, and our faith in God is something that I think is propelling us, okay, into the boxing scene. And it's not because I'm a three-time world champion why my sons are coming up like they are right now. Yes, I truly believe that, you know, you can get some kind of, you know, genes passed down. And I think one of my boys have one of my power, and that's John. But Julian has the toughness. Julius has the toughness. John has the power. But both of them have good boxing skills. And I'm continuing to really, you know, push them in that area that they need to continue to respect the sport, you know, and don't allow themselves to get caught up in the scheme of things, in the glitters and the light, you know, but to be humble and, you know, just go out there and respect, you know, the opponents, respect boxing, respect, you know, people out there. And I think people will accept you and want to see you.
I definitely agree with that, man. Raising up humble and humble guys that care for the sport. That's definitely a great thing.
And that was definitely one of the most realest messages that I've ever heard. And I truly appreciate you for gracing us with that. I really do. Also, okay, I'm gonna ask you about another current fighter who's a big puncher. He's not necessarily your type of big, like a big puncher like you, but he's a big puncher. Keith One Time Thurman. What are your thoughts on him?
Who's that again?
Keith Thurman.
Keith, Thurman. Oh yeah, he's all right, you know. I think some fighters, you know, have potential to be good punchers, and their technique, you know. I tell you what, some fighters are born with the ability to punch hard, and I think I was one of them. you know, I just had a natural instinct to punch hard, but still, you know, I had a coach that I think, you know, put the icing on the cake and made me actually become a master in punching, and I was able to, you know, learn to actually time, you know, my body followed my fist. Every ounce of my right side of my body was from my fist. My left hook, every ounce of my body coming from the left side would actually react with the punch. And that's something I've been trying to teach my boys, and to really use the body. Split-second timing is the key. And if you hit anyone and you throw an arm punch, and they know that that's the best you can do, they're gonna come straight in at you. But if you hit them with your body, if you hit them with your shoulders, your hip, your knees, your elbow, I mean your ankles, your toes, and you put everything into the punch, I guarantee you they're not going to want to come back in and get punched like that again. You know, and again, it's a lot of hard work and timing.
Okay.
I definitely agree with you. It's always technique and timing. My question, speaking of your power, I know you get fight fans, and probably your sons growing up, it's just amazing how great of a puncher you were. I want to know, have you ever just sit back, or maybe after a fight, after one of your big knockouts, and sit back in amazement, like, dang, I possess this type of power, and just been blowing yourself away by how much, you know, damage you can do with your fists?
No, not really. tell the truth, never really. You know, I always go in the ring asking God to protect me and my opponent. And, you know, I guess the way I train is the way I fight. And when I train, you know, you got to stop and look and be amazed, because, you know, my trainer always had to tell me, okay, Julian, that's it. You will never hear my trainer telling me, you need to do more. He would always tell me, Julian, that's enough. You know, I was that kind of, you know, athlete. And, you know, there are some athletes actually, I mean, a present to their coaches, a blessing to their coaches. Why? Because they work hard, they're disciplined, you know, and they give every ounce of their, you know, the time in the gym. And that's what makes a champion. That's what makes an athlete really to make it to the I think the place where others have to look and see, you know, what is going on with this guy, you know, what has this guy kicking. And that's the type of you know, fighter I was, the kind of athlete I was. And all the coaches that I work with, okay, always had to tell me, Julian, that's enough. And it's amazing. My sons now, today, you know, I push them, and I try to teach them and let them know that, you know, they have to work for what they want. If they want to be a world champion, if they want to be the best in the world, you know, they've got to, you know, step up, and they've got to, you know, put their shoulders to the wheel and grind and make this thing work. And that's what's happening right now.
I definitely respect that answer. You know, nothing like a hard worker that's already, you know, talented. Just adding hard work to it, and then the sky's the limit.
Exactly.
That's right. And again, man, I really appreciate you guys giving us this opportunity, you know, to heal up the fans around the world, and you know, just to, you know, give us a little publicity, and we really appreciate it. You know, coming from the Virgin Islands, you know, I always say that, you know, even though we are only a dot on the map, but we have a big heart, and we want to let the people know, the world know, okay? The hawk is still flying, you know, in the shadows of the sun.
Most definitely. Hey, I can tell you like this. This is honestly, I'm truly honored for you to do this interview. As I told you beforehand, I'm a huge fan of yours. When I tell you, I mean basically everything. Like I studied the way you put twerk in your punches. When I tell you I study you very well, I've studied you a whole lot because I'm a huge fan of yours. And honestly, I wish it was more fighters in today's world of boxing that were like you, who had the attitude, I'll fight anybody, anywhere. It don't matter. It don't matter your size, this, and that. Get in the ring, let's go, we'll fight. I respect fighters like that. So it's definitely an honor for you, for you even gracing us with this interview, sir.
Thank you very much, man, and we really appreciate it. And, you know, we hope that, maybe we can do some more, with
more fighters. We have a stable of fighters, to you. God bless you guys now.
Thank you very much.
All right, have a good night.
All right, thanks.
All right, YouTube, that's the end of the interview with Julian the Hulk Jackson. I'm still overexcited about even doing it because, as I mentioned a few times, that's one of my favorite fighters. I even did a video on him, but sorry about the carrying on. But you guys know the deal. Hit the like button for us. Go to the comment section, leave comments, and let us know what you guys thought about it. Also, go over to the YouTube page, hit the subscribe button for us. Keep showing us the love and support. Also, me and Big Kool. Big Smooth segment. So also go over to Facebook and hit the like button on Colossal Boxing Talk for us. Then you can go to Twitter and Instagram and follow us at Colossal CBT. This is Smooth Cat. Go ahead.
And don't forget, you can send us, phone requests. I'm the real Jasper. You just send me a phone request. I accept the little talking boxing and other things. And shout out, we want to shout out to our other brothers at CBT and John J. G. Corner, as well as Miguel.
Mighty Mouse Torres.
So, keep supporting us, like Mike said, leave us your feedback, what I'm saying, whether it's good or bad, just be respectful with how you difference of opinion from us, but like I said, we appreciate the support. We're going to keep bringing you bigger and better analysis, continue to bring you exclusive interviews, and just big thanks from us in 2015.
Smooth cut out.